Welcome back to Every Way Woman. So I keep hearing that I can't be Miss Wrong looking for Mr. Right. Anna, I know you're looking for love too. What does it mean to be Miss Wrong?
Well, first I want to know what is considered Miss
Right.
Wrong, you know, because I think I'm perfectly fine. I mean, I'm not saying like anybody that knows me, I'm not, like that
perfect,
I think
perfect.
You know
right.
what I mean? But I think I got everything going on for myself,
you, sure
you know?
Do.
Like, you know, so what, I mean, what is considered Miss Wrong?
Well, I think if I had to get, as a person, a woman carries a lot of baggage, a lot of hurt. Last relationship brings it to the new relationship and then expect the man to be right. That's how I would define Mrs.
Well, and
Wrong.
And also, a lot of women have these like big long checklists of what they expect out of their man. You know, he's got to be 6'2" and all of this stuff, but they're not bringing anything to the table.
Sunita, he
so
be
what
six
are they bringing?
Two. That's all right. Yeah. Yeah. That's
but,
all right.
But what if they meet the man of their life and he's 5'7"? Do they say, "Oh, I'm sorry, you don't make my list"?
No,
so
but
I can't.
I think it's all about having yourself together before you're going to attract the person that has all these qualities that you want as well.
I know, girl Lauryn Hill said it. How you gonna win when you ain't right within? You know? Sunita, but
poor girl.
Sunita,
right. But she's right. I mean, if the core is not right and it's not together, then you won't be fit for anybody.
I think,
you know, two wrongs don't make a right.
Okay, but I blame myself for a lot of the failures in my past relationships, and I can't really get over that. Mm-hmm. And so I feel like I'm still Ms. Wrong, and I don't know how to become Ms. Right to get
but
Mr. Right.
Don't apologize. Women, we love fast and we love hard. Mm-hmm. And so I don't want you to apologize for that.
That's
you
great.
Manage it, but don't apologize for that.
Mm-hmm. I think for me personally, it's the wrong timing. Like for me, especially everything that happened recently, it's like totally the wrong timing. So I want to give myself some more time before try to look.
What happened?
My boyfriend passed away 6 months ago. So it's you can't just go into another.
Right.
It's not,
no.
Like,
right.
To me, he was Mr. Right. So
you
how do you
right.
go look for another Mr. Right? You know what
Well, you know, you take that time to get yourself right. And then
that's
you
what
can,
I'm doing
you know,
right
be able
now.
To find it. But
well,
definitely.
I'll say for myself, when I was dating, I brought a lot of baggage, and I know I was Mrs. Wrong, and I was okay with that. I was doing something that was not right, had a lot of expectations, and then I wanted my mate to meet that, and he couldn't because I didn't understand. I didn't really know what I wanted.
And so. I think that speaks to you, Jeslyn, because I feel like, you know, with you're looking at these past relationships and, you know, you're trying to figure that out, but I think at this point, it's not even about the relationships. Are you good with yourself? Are you settled? You know, don't look at the relationship to fix you or give you something that's missing from you.
But I mean, can we just be real though? I mean, seriously. We think our husband's supposed to come on this white horse and galley up in our life. And really, my mama told me that the man might have one eyeball or wear glasses
Absolutely.
Or he might be 5'5".
Exactly.
You know, but as long as he treats you good,
Absolutely.
You should be comfortable
that's
with
Mr.
that.
Right.
No, I don't
yeah.
agree with that.
You don't
yeah.
agree with that?
I don't agree with that.
Why? I'm not going to be attracted to a man who has one eyeball.
Yeah, thank you.
So your husband got glasses.
Yes, he does. To a husband who has one eyeball, and I think as a woman, I don't have to settle. I don't have to settle.
That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah.
But I have a friend. He has one eyeball, and he's 6'1",
okay,
and
no,
he got into an injury. And just because he got a patch in his eye, don't make him no less attractive.
Amber, it's not about the patch in his eye. It's about not settling. And
that's
I think
right.
in this
that's
like
it.
Quest for love, sometimes then I settle because I'm in such a hurry to find that,
right.
Or compromise or sacrifice. Because I'm like, oh, well, you know, I don't have to worry about that. I shouldn't care about his one eyeball. So that's
right.
good enough for
See,
me.
See, you're still stuck on the one eyeball. I said he has a patch.
Oh,
now.
Come on.
That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying.
But I'm just saying, like, sometimes, though, that priority of looks is put up so high up there. And all the other stuff of how he treats you, what
Thank
he makes you,
you
feel,
Thank
is
you.
Nowhere
that's
on the list.
Okay.
It's not on the
it's
checklist.
It's important, ladies. But what I'm saying is, as women, let's not stay there.
Right.
Don't tell women that if you desire a handsome man, as long as he treats you right, he doesn't have to be handsome. I'm not selling that to my daughters. I'm telling him he can be fine and treat you right.
You get what you want, right?
But not everybody's gonna look like a Maura Chesnut or a Ryan Gosling.
Amber,
he's not
Amber, Amber.
Ain't nobody gonna look through the door
Amber,
like
he
that.
Does
he
Amber,
me, and he's not gonna be my daughter.
We can hope he looks like Ryan Gosling.
We sure
without
can.
Without the
I don't even know who Ryan Gosling is.
Oh, come
you
on.
Should look him up.
We'll be right back with more Every Way Woman.
I know who can
look here, guys.
I like Channing Tatum.
And for first of all, my